Home Sports Entertainment presents San Antonio Spurs basketball. Tonight's game is brought to you by Miller Lite, the only beer with the taste big enough for Texas. By Chevy Trucks, more people are winning with the heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet. By True Value Hardware Stores, got a tough job to do, they'll see you through it. You can do it with True Value Hardware Stores. By Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut is making it great. By your Texas Jeep Eagle dealers. And by Southwest Airlines, celebrating 20 years of loving you.
Live from Hemisphere Arena, Home Sports Entertainment presents San Antonio Spurs basketball. Tonight the Spurs play host to Sean Kemp, Dale Ellis, and the Seattle Supersonics. And we welcome you again to Hemisphere Arena. Spurs basketball with Dave Barnett along with Kobe Dietrich here on HSE. The Spurs try to continue a winning streak. They're going for five straight. They have lifted themselves with a little help into the second best overall record of the NBA, trailing only Portland. It's their first look at Seattle since late November, but it's a different Seattle team. They didn't have Dale Ellis back then. They didn't have Eddie Johnson back then. The Spurs Saturday night looked like a little bit different team, and in particular Terry Cummings looked like his old self, 26 points and 14 rebounds.
Well, Terry Cummings is one of the main guys on this Spurs team. When you're in the locker with him, when you're traveling with him, you know he's been hurt, you know he hasn't been feeling all that well, and I think it affects people, but to see him really turn it on in that game, I think affected the whole team. Everybody's real happy that he's starting to feel better.
Larry Brown would agree to that assessment. He says when Terry is down, the team seems to be down with him. On the other hand, when Terry feels good and his game shows it, a young team is going to respond to that.
You know, we're still a young team, and a lot of our guys haven't been through it night in and night out. And when you expect 22 points or 23 points and 8.5 rebounds a game and you're not getting it, it puts a lot of pressure on some of the other guys. And that's really affected us because, you know, I think Terry is a proven scorer. And when he's not scoring, other guys are starting to do things they're not capable of doing, and everybody gets out of sync. So it makes me feel more comfortable, and I know it makes the team.
The Seattle front line is going to look different than they did November 27th up in Seattle. They made a blockbuster deal on December 7th. They sent to the Phoenix Suns Xavier McDaniel, and the Suns hope he's their final piece of a championship puzzle. They got Eddie Johnson as a sixth man. His scoring is better, but look at the two starting forwards ahead of him. Sean Kemp, who moves into power forward, and Derek McKee, who moves from power forward to small forward. And Kobe, it looks like a change that has bettered everybody all the way around.
Well, it's really helped Seattle in that those three players that we just saw, their situation has changed. And the teams are dynamic. You take one guy out and everybody else's responsibilities change. And these three guys have responded to that.
Dale Ellis, also not a part of that game in late November. He was on the injured list with a foot problem. He's back, but the numbers aren't quite there. But 10 points per game below what Sonic fans have seen from him over the last four seasons. Second meeting of the year, Spurs and Seattle, coming up on Home Sports Entertainment.
Genuine draft. For those who've discovered its real draft taste, the world is a very cool place.
Must be a Lennox.
So we put in this new heat pump and our bills are really
down.
Exactly.
Must be a Lennox.
Charlie, the Johnsons are having something delivered.
Mm-hmm.
It's a new heat pump.
That's nice, dear.
What system is so great they buy it this early?
Must be a Lennox.
Must be a Lennox.
With a bigger box than Ford Ranger, a Chevy S10 Maxi Cab can easily carry an entire room full of stuff and still have enough truck left over to give you a comfortable family room with four chairs. More people are winning with today's Chevy truck.
Chevy Sportside. Stepside styling that turns some heads. Biggest standard V6 in its class to turn some revs. Another reason more people are switching to the heartbeat of America.
If you're not recycling, you're throwing it all away.
That our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
National anthem as another big crowd filing in at Hemisphere Arena for the Spurs and the Supersonics. And the Spurs at 29-10, the Supersonics at 19-20. They've lost six straight on the road, but on a given night, especially if their press is working, they can give anybody trouble. In fact, this is the last team to defeat the LA Lakers, who have won, as of yesterday afternoon's victory, Boston, 11 straight games. Starting lineups brought to you by Southwest Airlines as usual. And for the Supersonics, as we said, it's a little different than what they saw last time. Sean Kemp, just 21 years of age, but in his second year out of Trinity Valley Junior College. And Derek McKee from Alabama at the forwards. Michael Cage, just 6'9", is the center. Dale Ellis and Gary Payton, the second pick in the draft out of Oregon State, are the guards. And the usual five for the Spurs with Cummings, Elliott, Robinson, Anderson, and Strickland. All the way back on November 27th, the Spurs needed a 29-14 fourth quarter to overcome the Sonics, 124-111. If you're Larry Brown, the question is, with all the changes that the Supersonics have made since late November, do you completely throw out your old scouting report?
Well, not really. I've always respected Seattle. I've always wondered why they don't win more. But I think now they're playing about the way I thought they would. Since they got rid of McDaniel, they've gone to a bigger front line, and they don't have everybody on the front line trying to score, which has made them much more effective. They become a better rebounding team with Polonese and Cage. And then with Ellis playing now, they have a pretty good outside-inside mix. And then they have Eddie Johnson coming off the bench. And even though he has the same mentality as McDaniel, he doesn't need the ball as much. So I think they're probably as athletic as any team in the league, and they do an amazing job on the board. And we gotta see that we can rebound with them effectively and not turn the ball over. If we do those things, I think we'll be all right.
Supersonics trying to get to 500 with a victory. Dale Ellis, the 8-year pro from Tennessee, all-time three-point leader in NBA history, 589 over his career and 21 this year. 2 years ago, the three-point shootout champion at All-Star Weekend in Houston. But rounding into form tonight, just his 17th game as a starter since they moved him into the lineup, they're a winning team. The Spurs already assured of being the best Spur team ever. At the halfway point last year, they won 28. They've already upped it to 29 with tonight and tomorrow night at Houston still remaining before the actual halfway mark in the season. Tonight's tip of the game brought to you by True Value Hardware Stores. For a natural finish on your next woodworking project, use a Danish oil finish instead of a polyurethane varnish. Danish oil penetrates deep into wood for that hand-rubbed look. That's tonight's True Value tip of the game. Our officiating crew, Mike Mathis, Jack Nees, Ron Oleziak. And the Spurs and Supersonics are ready. The Admiral winning the tap. Elliott with an immediate advantage against Peyton. Outside Strickland over to Willie Anderson, and Ellis left him free, and it's 2-0. Spurs with outstanding balance in the win over the Wolves Saturday. Willie a part of that with 17 points. Dumped down low, Kemp powers it in.
Well, a really quick move from Sean Kemp to the basket. David wasn't quite quick enough getting over. I don't think anyone expected him to move that quickly all the way to the hoop.
Sean Kemp, who never played college basketball. Prop 48 candidate, casualty, and went to junior college, but never played in junior college. High post, Robinson makes it 4-2. One mark of Seattle games this year, high shooting percentages by them and by whoever they play, and Dale Ellis draws the first foul of the game. Terry Cummings on the baseline.
Terry Cummings ends up picking up Dale Ellis and just sort of gives him a little shoulder there and didn't quite get away with that play. Dale Ellis is a very, very difficult guy to guard. He's got great range. And you got to be up close to him to keep him from shooting a three-pointer. And yet he's capable of going by you either way, taking it all the way to the hoop.
What Seattle was able to do after they got him from Dallas was make him a guard. He was a swing man to Dallas off the bench, never got adjusted to either forward or guard. And Casey Jones was still at Boston when this happened, but when they installed Ellis as the starting off guard, he took off and basically has not looked back. An all-star ever since.
Here we just saw just a little bit of the press. Seattle's known to press full court as much of the time as they can, trying to force turnover.
That athletic ability that Larry Brown was talking about. Terry Cummings from 20, and the Spurs are 3-for-3. Sonics with the pressure, but statistically, they don't play a great brand of defense. They're a pretty easy team to shoot against if you break the press. Ellis turned away. And Strickland leading the 3-on-2 to Willie Anderson, short, and the tap by Cummings.
Well, you see how frisky Terry Cummings is as he made it down the court to follow that shot in. He's starting to feel better.
Been a while since we've seen him make a play like that. In the corner is Kemp and Cage. Right back to him. He's got two slam dunks, and it's 8-5. Kim, just a specimen, 6'10", 240, with an outside shot, can run the floor, block shots. Their leading rebounder. Ellis chasing Anderson off the screen, and Willie to shoot two. The first foul on the Sonics is on Ellis. Larry Brown hoping for a 17-3 home record after tonight. And a fifth consecutive victory.
Well, as Willie Anderson gets the free throws here, I'm sure David Robinson is aware that Sean Kemp has dunked the ball twice in his neighborhood in the early parts of this game. I think he's storing that away for later use.
One of two. They get Cummings as he thought McKee went over his back, and that's two on Terry Cummings. See if he had an argument.
Terry steps in and gets underneath Michael Cage here. And didn't seem to have anything happen there and got the foul called.
Cage outside over to Kemp. Handled the ball just about every possession. First block of the night, Robinson. And it went out of bounds. Still belongs to Seattle.
Well, here's Kemp once more trying to take it to the hoop against David. He just lays back and throws that one back.
McKee got his attention. Your point was well made. McKee short, Strickland control. Spurs look to run. This new look fast break, very effective over the last week and off the back of the iron for the Rocket. Seattle still down 9-5. And Anderson, look how far out he picks up Ellis. Literally a threat anywhere in the half court set. Casey Jones up for a 20-second timeout. Well, the Spurs at 29-10 trail only one team, and that is Portland in the entire NBA with the Lakers' 11-game win streak and their victory over Boston. They tied the Celtics for third best overall, and then Chicago is just a game behind Los Angeles and Boston. So I guess it's the Spurs' ill fortune to be in the same conference with Portland.
Well, I think Portland obviously has been the best team in the league all year. A little bit of that is just the ebb and flow of the scheduling. I mean, right now the Spurs are looking at a whole slew of home games. I was talking with Dave Corzine. Seattle's looking at just two home games between now and February 22nd, which is, you know, that's just sort of the way the schedule works out when you're halfway through the season.
Shot clock at 11. And Gary Payton with the no-look feed for Ellis's first three-pointer, and it's on the mark. 22nd of the year, 590th of his career.
He's put a lot of them down in this building. Seems to shoot very well here in Hemisphere Arena.
Elliott unable to post on Kemp. Robinson calling for it. He's got about a 5-inch height advantage over Michael Cage. They haven't fouled him in a half-court set yet. Anderson from 20. On the mark again, and Willie with 5 of the first 11.
Two set shots, too. Not the shots you usually expect to see from Willie Anderson.
Might be a good sign. Point blank steal, Robinson. Saw Kemp was looking the other way and took advantage. Elliott alone over McKee, too much. And Cummings again on the offensive glass, active early. Terry Cummings with 6. McKee leaning in, then falling away on Elliott. And another Strickland rebound. Anderson. And Elliott. And not there for Sean in the early going. The unusual aspect of the win Saturday, it was the first time since December 5th that both Elliott and Cummings have had 20 points in the same game. And you'll get Elliott for contact in the lane, his first third against the team.
There we saw just a little glimpse of Derek McKee's passing ability. The year they were taking, Scottie Pippen of Chicago and Derek McKee were 2 6'9" forward guards, potential guards in the NBA coming out of college. And both of them, I think, have turned into really fine pros.
If Pippen taken 4 in Chicago in a prearranged deal. Some people consider him an all-star. Stolen by Cage. Sonics can come within one, perhaps tie. First Spur turnover of the night. 7:20 mark of the period, and despite Robinson being in the neighborhood, Kemp put extra arc on it. He's got 6. It's a one-point game.
Boy, he really has made some quick moves. I think he's just surprised David several times.
Now Robinson with a mismatch against Ellis, and Strickland spots him in time. Now, he's had a mismatch every time down. That's really the first time they've noticed, and the lead is back to 3. And you also notice Anderson almost at midcourt to pick up Ellis. The idea, make him work as hard as he can to get the ball. Tire him out before he shoots. Payton miss. Rebound Kemp. Double clutch for the follow. 15-14. 8 for Sean Kemp. How good would he be if he played college basketball?
Maybe tired of it by now. He sure plays with a lot of enthusiasm.
Strickland turning on Payton. And Robinson was there again. Now Rocket starting to look for the Admiral.
This is Willie doing everything he can to front Ellis, keep him from getting it.
Over to help briefly with Strickland. Now Ellis able to back him down. Willie thought maybe he tied him up, but it'll be his first and the team's fourth foul. Timeout, 6:06 first quarter. The Spurs 17, the Sonics 14.
Once again, it's time to
fire up the new Eagle Talon. And you've got a power tool that handles like a dream in the corners. Cuts clean across any surface. And nails the competition every time. Eagle Talon, the one power tool you won't be so willing to lend to the guy next door.
See your Texas Jeep Eagle dealer, where you can expect the best. Now there's a great new pizza with all the pepperoni you want and more.
Yeah, pepperoni!
It's the new Pizza Hut Pepperoni Supreme. With tons of pepperoni to keep you satisfied. Plus all the mushrooms, onions, and green peppers to make it supreme. And now for limited time, get a medium pepperoni supreme for only $6.99. It's the new pan pizza you've always wanted. And now it's all yours.
Pizza Hut, making it great.
San Antonio now has a personal injury law firm with national resources and local ties. The law firm is here for you and because of you. When you walk through our door, you become the most important person we know.
Let's go home, kids. It's our job to serve you. It's our choice to care. I'm Ron Mata.
The talent you expect, the experience you deserve. Spicer, Krauss, Madol, and Mendelson Mata, San Antonio's national law firm.
Let's look at what's on tap for the Spurs on HSE. 7:30 Tuesday, February 5th, our next HSE telecast. Here against the Golden State Warriors, 7:30 the following Thursday the 7th, here against Indiana. And Tuesday the 12th, here against the Washington Bullets. All three games live on HSE. 17-14 Spurs, 6:06 in the period. And Dale Ellis will be at the stripe. Already some adjustments for both teams. The Sonics making the Spurs adjust to Sean Kemp. And Casey Jones making the Sonics try to keep the pace as lively as possible, but the Spurs ready for that. They picked him up high.
Well, David's been matched up against Sean Kemp. I think, you know, he just hasn't ever seen him before. And Sean Kemp's been very effective. I think the other thing we're seeing is the Sonics aren't pressing.
Good drive. Elliott missed the jam. Cummings, another offensive rebound and the putback. Haven't kept him off the board yet.
Two really good plays. They just can't figure out where Terry Cummings is and don't seem to be blocking him out.
Three times he's got putbacks for a total of 8 points. They isolate Kemp on the Admiral. Made him take a horrible shot, and it's rebounded by Cummings. Spurs again with a man advantage, and it's Strickland all the way this time. So a 5-point lead, a high-risk Sonic system. High in that if they give it up, they don't have the advantage defensively. And then on the other hand, if they get through you, that's where they get their offense in gear. They force a lot of turnovers, but they will also turn it over themselves, as McKee does here. Their third of the period.
As we go through the game, you watch Willie Anderson lined up against Dale Ellis. Dale Ellis has got such great upper body strength. He's real difficult to keep the ball from. He'll bounce off of you and get open in order to get the ball. Willie's doing everything he can to prevent him from getting it.
Cage out on Cummings, and TC with his first miss, rebounded by Kemp. Good job by the Spurs getting back. Sonics have been unable to run so far. Cage bangs it in from the baseline. He's got four. And again, the full court pressure. A little more serious this time.
They seem to be falling back in it. I think they were pretty effective against the Spurs up in Seattle with the press, but I think it was late in the game the Spurs sort of figured it out. You know, you think maybe that Casey Jones is trying to maybe spring it on him a little bit later, just try to stay in the game and use it a little bit later in the game.
Foul was on McKee for grabbing Robinson. His first and the team's second. Ellis on Strickland this time. Anderson against the bigger man, McKee, and they got Payton in the mismatch on Cummings, but it's a long two for Anderson. Again, that knack of having one toe over the stripe. Cage, 3 for 3 from at least 15 feet.
Real good hustle from Willie Anderson and good ball movement by Seattle. Willie tried to pick off that pass, the swing pass. When he got burned by it, he just went immediately to the guy that was open, Michael Cade.
Sonics back to the normal defensive alignment here. The long range shot won't fall for Strickland. Ellis soaring for the rebound. They can again cut it to one, perhaps tie. 3.5 minute mark. Payton in deep. Kemp, too deep. Knocked out by Robinson of the foot race won by Ellis. But then Anderson there to knock it off of It looked like Ellis's leg. They say off Willard.
Well, Ellis picks up his loose ball. And it looks like it bounced off Willie's. Willie was the guy that pointed, so it probably went off his foot.
It, I think, did. And the fact that he didn't argue would lend credence. And there's the ultimate angle right there. Good call. David Greenwood in for the Spurs along with Paul Pressey.
Now it's Pressey's job to deal with Dale Ellis.
Should be up to the task as much as anybody is. And he forces the air ball right off the bat. Every time down, Spurs look to run, and knocked away from Robinson by Kemp. That is one on Kemp, three on the team, and a Sonic timeout with 2:57 to the first quarter. High scoring game early on at Hemisphere, and Brown and the Spurs on top by three.
The reason Robert isn't leaving is not because he doesn't want to be beaten on the basketball court. It's because he doesn't want to be beaten at home.
If you know of or suspect a case of child abuse, do something about it.
This message is brought to you by Laurel Ridge.
Why should you buy from Smith Chevrolet? Stability. We're a three-generation family business, and we've been selling Chevrolets for nearly 75 years. Service. Our parts department is one of the largest anywhere, and our service and body shop is state-of-the-art. Price. We know our prices will stand up to anybody's every day on every Chevy, because we'll do what it takes. Come see us at Smith Chevrolet GO on Broadway. We'll do what it takes.
Best time to buy quality, name brand furniture is now, during Stowers Winter Sale. Save 30 to 60% on every living room, family room, bedroom, and dining room. Plus, add the finishing touch with a perfect decorative accessory. All at tremendous savings. Stowers, a San Antonio tradition for over 100 years.
Two excellent candidates to join Terry Cummings Club teammates. They are 14 and under. I bet they can muster up the $13.95 membership fee. It includes a TC signature hat, autographed picture, two packs of NBA Hoops trading cards, a membership card, and an invitation to a Spurs practice. Application form at every Sunday's Express News or by calling 554-SPUR for more details. And an outstanding start for Terry tonight. 4 of 5 from the field, 8 points. 4 rebounds as he checks the jalapeno count on his cabana. Brought to you by Taco Cabana, up to 4. And counting, 23-20. Robinson at the line, 2:57 in the period. David had led 10 straight games in scoring. He led points and rebounds, 21 of the last 25 games until Saturday. He got some help. He only got 9 shots off. Wolves decided to make him win it at the line if he was going to win it. And Elliott and Cummings responded with outstanding game. Cage out against Greenwood. Robinson on McKee, and McKee with his own rebound, and then Eddie Johnson will throw it off the leg of Sean Elliott. Johnson, who just came in, their top scorer off the bench.
Well, that was a sort of a weak shot McKee put up over David Robinson, but boy, what a spectacular rebound and pass he put off just then.
Sonics, the best offensive rebounding team in the NBA. Fourth best rebounding team, period.
There you saw again, another no-look pass, just a real clever pass from Derek McKee for the layup.
And a steal for Ellis. He's got only Strickland to worry about, and Nate McMillan will lay it in, and we're tied. That is what the Sonics team is all about. Take it away and break away, 24-all.
Well, they don't really have the big people, so I think they're going to gamble on doing something to defense out on the floor.
In traffic underneath, they again put Robinson on the stripe. Michael Cage with his first, and now each team with 4.
And there you can see right there that David, Michael Cage is not, doesn't look from here as big as David Greenwood, and yet he's playing center against David Robinson.
Well, I don't think he is as big as Greenwood. Listed at 6'9 and 230. Olden Polonese, a true center. And Sedale three, having easily the best year of his career, ready to come in. 30 double-doubles, well on his way to bettering last year. One of two again. Spurs in danger of losing their lead late first quarter. Three out of West Virginia Tech, former sixth-round pick of Philadelphia, 8 years in the league. Eddie Johnson turns on Elliott, had a hand at his face, and there's another offensive rebound, and McKee with the jam. Sonics have their first lead at 26-25. This is what Larry Brown was talking about. Athletic ability that will match up with about anybody in the league, and it really shows itself on the offensive glass. Good look inside Robinson to Greenwood, and Greenwood will be on the line. Eddie Johnson with his first.
So David ends up getting real deep in the paint here. Polonese behind him as he turns. That's McKee that comes to help, and David Greenwood underneath gets fouled by Eddie Johnson.
David Greenwood. Robinson replaced by Sidney Green. David Greenwood.
Now David Robinson took a little bit of an elbow, and McKee went up for that offensive, that jam just a minute ago.
Avery Johnson in for Rod Strickland.
John Anderson's over there looking at him.
And how often do we say this? Not a good sign for the concentration to be so amiss at the line. They are 4 for 8, counting that one. And all even. McMillan guarded by Avery Johnson, just checking in, replacing Strickland. Clear out McKee, over Green with the jumper. Another offensive board and a putback by McMillan, and it's the Sonics by two. Kobe up to the Spurs to do some blocking out, because this is nothing surprising at all from Seattle.
What the Sonics do really well is they have dangerous people, and Eddie Johnson and Dale Ellis and these guys, and I think the Spurs are paying a little bit more attention to them than they ought to. And their own men are slipping in, getting offensive rebounds.
Elliott with the turnover, and then too late to stop Eddie Johnson from spotting up. So 4 for Eddie Johnson, and the margin is 4. 10-2 run by the Sonics. Not much happening inside for the Spurs since Robinson caught him unawares a couple of times. Shot clock down to 4. Green, a desperation three-pointer. And Polonese and Greenwood battle, and David Greenwood is there for the putback. A page out of the Sonics' first quarter playbook. 30-28, 6 seconds. Sonics work for the last shot. And it is ripped away from McKee by Sidney Green. And out of bounds, the Spurs with that much time to work with. So they'll get Strickland and Anderson back in. And remember our last HSE telecast, what Willie did at the end of the first half of that game. Threw in about a 40-footer. Inbounds, turning is Elliott, got it off, and just short at the buzzer. But the Supersonics, with a 10-4 run at the end of the first quarter, lead it by 2. 30-28 here on HSE.
You're watching Spurs basketball on Home Sports Entertainment.
It's time to head to Benny's TV and Appliance for great deals and a new Zenith. This 19-inch diagonal color television is only $197. This large 25-inch diagonal remote control cable compatible console is only $497. And right now, get Benny's best price on a Zenith VCR. When you shop at Benny's, you're shopping with the largest locally owned independent selling Zenith in San Antonio for 19 years. Benny's TV and Appliance, with 5 locations to serve you.
Toman Mitsubishi, the word is getting around, and customer satisfaction is a reason why, before, during, and after the sale. Gilman Mitsubishi wants you to win $1,000. How? Match the last six digits of your Social Security number with the last six digits of any vehicle serial number and win $1,000. You don't want to miss this sale. Take I-35 North to the Selma Schertz exit. Gilman Mitsubishi, the word is getting around.
San Antonio now has a personal injury law firm with national resources and local ties.
Spicer, Craftsman, Dole, and Mendelson Mata.
When you walk through our door, you become the most important person we know. A team with the talent you expect, the experience you deserve, and we're paid only when you recover. Spicer, Krauss, Madol, and Mendelson Mata, San Antonio's national law firm, 222-2271.
Southwest Airlines game summary after the first quarter. Both teams shooting well. Both power forwards off to good starts. Offensive rebounding telling the story in the Sonics' road from behind. They had a 10-4 spurt late in the quarter. They lead 30-28. And their ball opening quarter number two.
Larry Brown sort of reflecting the size of the Seattle team. Larry Brown's got an unusual combination in right now. And Willie Anderson and Avery Johnson at the guards. Paul Pressey is actually playing a guard on defense and guarding McMillan.
And Sedale three knows all about Avery Johnson. Former teammates last couple of years. Three at 6'2", about a 3-4 inch advantage. And a takeaway, and they won't catch Sedale three.
There you run into the problem of having an unusual lineup is that David Greenwood, Avery Johnson threw the ball to David Greenwood, who's not a guard, wasn't looking for that ball. Neither Willie Anderson nor Paul Pressey were playing the guard position. Avery Johnson didn't know where to throw that first pass. Three took advantage of it.
Well, a familiar sight. Five turnovers. Losing his footing, McMillan. He gives it right back. Greenwood spots Johnson, and he'll roll it in. Avery Johnson against his former teammates. They sent him to Denver for number two early this year. Not the type to hold grudges, though. This may be a night where the Spurs need that part of his personality to change. Holden Holliday's planting himself in the lane for the jump hook.
Now Dave Corzine before the game had a lot of nice things to say about Avery Johnson. He was really impressed with him as a player and a guy and a person.
Pressey thought he saw Anderson, and the save right back to Pressey at midcourt. Good hustling play by Sean Kemp. And we may have a shot clock problem. They have reset it to 24. And we're ready to go. 36-30 Sonics, their biggest lead of the game. Anderson all the way through. Maybe a fire can be lit. 36-32. This is not the way the first half went against Minnesota. It's starting to look that way. Anderson with Green and knocked away by McMillan. Outstanding defensive play, and Nate may have banged a tooth for his trouble. Spurs came out extremely fired up, and for parts of the game Saturday looked like this, just toying with the Wolves in the open court. McMillan prevented that here. And he stays in. The three-pointer no good by Pressey. Green on the offensive glass and out of bounds. It'll still belong to the Spurs. Well, that emotion has been fleeting, though. We've seen it sometimes when we didn't expect to see it. When we did expect to see it, we haven't seen it this year. Tough thing to predict.
Well, it looks like for the guys that want to work out, here's David Greenwood working real hard in deep. The guys that want to work at it, I think the Sonics will give up position inside if you can get the offensive rebound. And Terry Cummings had a field day when he was in the first quarter.
Greenwood a good spark since he checked in. They have cut the margin to two. Again, McMillan posting on Johnson. McMillan, a big guard at 6'5". Anderson came over to help, and Greenwood has Johnson, another breakaway.
Well, good rebounding traffic by David Greenwood. Even a better outlet pass as he immediately recognized that Avery Johnson was open.
Timeout, Casey Jones. Six straight Spur points to knot it at 36-all.
It's time now for you to be a star.
We Brits are learning your American football. Right, Joe?
Yeah. Right.
The other way! Catch the ball!
And after practice, we drink a great American beer. Miller Lite.
Miller Lite, with its crisp, refreshing Pilsner taste, it's everything you want in a beer today.
What are they doing now?
They're practicing touchdowns.
They say the memory goes first, not mine. This brings back everything. It's an old-fashioned patty melt. I used to have it on the shore. Oh, it's such a juicy burger with cheese melting over everything, lots of grilled onions and bacon, and then they would grill it on rye bread, just like this one.
Introducing the old-fashioned patty melt. It's a classic at Jack in the Box.
No, no, my memory is good as ever.
You?
Yeah, me.
Russ, you have no eye for color.
I'm picking out the paint. I know what I'm doing. I have no idea what I'm doing.
You can do it, Russ. This TruTest custom color system makes it easy to match colors, just like a decorator.
Admit it, Ellen. I picked out the perfect colors.
Yes, but who would ever believe it?
You can do it with True Value Hardware Stores.
Here we have a replay of Willie Anderson taking the ball. The hoop. He goes right by Olden Polonese and just explodes to the back at basket. That was McMillan trying to do something about it and help. But Willie just really showing some athletic ability here in the first half.
Cut underneath Eddie Johnson with a step on Willie Anderson. Six for EJ off the bench.
Speaking of athletic ability, Eddie Johnson's so dangerous coming off the pick that you trail him, and you have to trail him. And if you do, he'll just curl right around and get the easy layup.
Polonese rebounding the miss by Anderson. Sonics run. Eddie Johnson, one of the great spot-up shooters in basketball over the last 10 years.
You said, notice he even waited for a second for some of his teammates to get down in a position to rebound.
Hard to see that they've lost anything without Xavier McDaniel. Johnson a little bit older, plus they got some number one picks. Anderson twice with a miss. Knocked away from Greenwood. Still the Spurs ball.
Boy, Willie Anderson really showing some aggressive offense. This looked really good. He knew he'd gotten up a bad shot and went right after the rebound. Both three guys pounding the offensive boards there.
Bressy turns on Nate McMillan and Threet standing out of bounds when he ripped that ball away. I was hoping nobody would notice. Last 3-4 minutes, the Spurs is much more into it. I think the Sonics got their attention with that run. Bressy on the penetration, the long two-pointer. Avery Johnson is off and knocked around to Greenwood. And then off Green, back to Avery Johnson. Weaving his way in, off Eddie Johnson. Green has it right back, and off Eddie Johnson.
Well, you can see the athleticism of the Seattle team. It just went off the fingertips of Eddie Johnson on the full run. Gives it a kick for good measure.
And they've got him a delay of game warning. Bressy, room to operate. He'll go to the line. Threet, the helping defender, came out along with McMillan. Sadeo with his first. For those of you with loved ones in Operation Desert Storm, Barry's Catering Video is offering a free service at all of its locations. Today through February 2nd, Barry's will provide a camcorder, a free video cassette, and shipping materials for mailing a custom 3-minute video message. Call Barry's Camera and Video Stores for details. Operation Desert Storm, they were able to enjoy the Super Bowl, some of them yesterday. And Pressey looking for his first point. 0 for 5 Saturday. Still 54% from the field for the year. And every time, Spurs making one of two. Every trip to the line, missed one and made one. Johnson chased by Anderson. Robinson back in, asserts himself, and stolen away by McMillan. Kemp out to Johnson for the three-pointer.
few words from the crowd as he turns after that three-pointer.
Well, they let him have it. They wanted him to get a tee after he kicked the ball, and he filed a few comments away. Sonics going to the trap. Strickland beats it. Pressey all alone. Cummings again working on the offensive glass and can't come up with this one. It's McMillan. One of the better rebounding guards. Something slippery over there. Three found it and turned it over. Pressey to Cummings. Off the rim, he wanted to alley-oop to Anderson. Pressey wanted to draw contact and didn't. And the Sonics still up by six. Look for more. They get it from three. Second lowest draft pick active in the NBA in the sixth round of 1983. Makes it 45-37. And the Spurs use time, 6:35 in the first half.
Fire up the new Eagle Talon, and you've got a power tool that handles like a dream in the corners. Cuts clean across any surface and nails the competition every time. Eagle Talon, the one power tool you won't be so willing to lend to the guy next door.
See your Texas Jeep Eagle dealer, where you can expect the best.
KSAT is your home for Spurs basketball. KSAT and the Spurs, the best sports teams in town.
Quality for quality, America's Diamond guarantees that our everyday manufacturer's prices are lower than the retail jeweler's very best sale prices, or will refund the difference plus 25%. We cast, set, and finish every diamond ring we sell. So when you buy direct from America's Diamond, you cut out the retail middlemen and save 50 to 75% off the suggested retail prices found at the big retail chain stores. Never buy a diamond without looking at it under a microscope. Let us show you the basics of diamond grading so you can compare and judge for yourself.
Well, if you watched Boston Garden yesterday, a show by Magic Johnson and the Lakers, 22 points and 15 assists for the Lakers in their 11th consecutive win. They are now 30 and 11 percentage points behind the Spurs. If the Spurs don't come from behind and win here, then they are surpassed for the number two record in the Western Conference. Down eight, 45-37, a 9-1 Seattle run. They've hit seven of their last 10 from the field, and the Spurs have missed five straight. Eddie Johnson with his second team second foul.
Eddie Johnson and Olden Polonese had to switch as Sean put a pretty good pick on Polonese. They created the switch. Eddie Johnson was trying to front David Robinson there and got called for the foul.
Illegal defense this time against Seattle. Spurs set up with Strickland and Robinson in a two-man game. And Casey Jones puzzled. By the way, the only Texas native as a head coach in the NBA. Native of Taylor. Not terribly far from here. Nobody ever talks about Casey Jones, the Texan. Three-pointer. Sean Elliott gets on the board in a big way and cuts the margin to five. Sean, one for five, ending that scoreless streak by the Spurs. And the Spurs pick it up a notch in the half court. All the starters are back in. Polonese inside of Robinson.
So you saw Terry Cummings do two different things. As Eddie Johnson curled around his man, the pick guy, he bumped Eddie Johnson, was helping his teammate. There he helped Rod Strickland on the pick and roll, got burned as Polonese took it to the hoop.
47-40. Anderson pull up jumper, deadly in the lane, and a double figure half for Willie. He's got 11. Lead back down to five. McMillan into the circle. Eddie Johnson. Lots of shooters out there. When you look at Ellis, Eddie Johnson, They haven't gone yet to Quentin Daly. He just shredded the Spurs up in Seattle in November. On the injured list until a few days ago. Another part of their arsenal they can call on. Anderson really feeling it here in the first half.
There's a lot of talent on this floor right now.
Johnson, stop and go. Deadly. He's got that look. When he's got that look, you're not going to do anything to slow him down. 9 for 11. 19 Eddie Johnson points. Strickland way over the head of Elliott, and he came down out of bounds. Here's what happens when Eddie Johnson heats up. A couple of games ago, he hit his first 7 from the field at Phoenix Saturday. The previous game, he had hit his last 8, so that gave him a club record 15 straight field goals over 2 games.
That'll get it done.
61% over his last 3 games. Ellis popping open in the corner. And not often will he miss those. Off Polity, Spurs get it back. This game really turned when Johnson came in off the bench. The HEB hustle stats show a 1-point edge overall. 4 blocks, the key for the Spurs. Well, 2:57 to go in the first quarter when Johnson came in, and it was a 3-point game at that juncture, 23-20. Right now it's 7. Robinson down the lane, and the second won't go. The third won't go. Neither will the fourth. The fifth never had a chance. It's knocked out to Ellis.
Boy, Sean Kemp just playing up real big with David, trying to, tap that ball in. Sean Kemp was right there going up with him.
Kemp pick and roll from Payton, who's back in, and they may call him for the clearing elbow. They will. Offensive foul. It's on Polonies.
Offensive foul on number 0, Olden Polonies.
Looks like they might get Kemp for the elbow. It's the first on Olden Polonies.
Well, I didn't see this one. Looked like they got Sean Kemp, who just cleared David's arm out as he went to the hoop. I think they might have called it on the wrong guy.
On number 40, Sean.
Yeah, they did, and they correct themselves here. It is number 2 on Kemp.
Second.
And a stolen inbounds pass by Payton to Ellis. A gift bucket, and Seattle goes up by 9. Spurs have just got to concentrate, because every time they have a lapse, they pay for it.
Well, they've put a little bit more pressure on in the full court, and the Spurs have made some errors.
Well, a season-long problem protecting the basketball, really hurting him. Anderson knifing in. He's got 15. Next high, Spur has 8.
We got Sean Elliott really working hard against Eddie Johnson.
And we're going to get Sean. He says Johnson flopped on me. And a technical foul for his trouble.
Well, this is one of those plays really hard to call. Both players trying to get low and bumping each other out of position. And they finally called Sean Elliott there. Could have gone either way. And I think Sean was right about being upset about it.
Veteran play by Eddie Johnson, because the contact he chose to flop on was nothing more than the previous 4 or 5 bumps. He just picked his spot and knew when the official was looking and went for it. Sonics again can go up 9. 3-12 first half. Ellis cannot get the ball. Outstanding defense by Anderson. It's McKee from the corner, and he's short. Michael Cage back in. Anderson blocking him. McKee down to Elliott, knocked away. Finally corralled by Sean. And a backcourt foul on Gary Payton.
Pretty smart play here by Payton as he corrals Strickland at 3-quarter court, but he got the foul called on him. But he really, the Spurs were on their way to a good fast break.
And Robinson finally had some position. His first points of the quarter. It's a 5-point game. And a 20-second timeout that the Sonics do not own. If they call a time here, that's going to cost a full timeout for Casey Jones. He's forgotten that he already took his 20 back in the first.
Well, I think Casey Jones trying to take the crowd out of it a little bit. The crowd's starting to get excited. Robinson just tipped dunk one.
Well, the let's look at it again, in fact. First, really, we've heard from David this quarter.
Here's Eddie Johnson's trying to hold him. Well, not trying very hard to hold him off.
Not hard enough.
David's just standing there and threw that one down. Michael Cage just really doesn't have a chance. You know, Michael Cage is the rebounder. If everybody blocks out their man, then Michael Cage has kind of got to get every rebound. But he can't go against two guys.
Well, tonight's San Antonio Spurs telecast is brought to you in part by Jack in the Box Restaurants. For exciting new taste, this is the place. Well, for a team that's lost six straight on the road, Sonics don't look that way. Again, it's another night where a team can get a nice pelt to put on the wall, and it's up to the Spurs to realize that. And I think intellectually they do realize that. I mean, they always talk about how everybody comes to play them now. It's not like last year. They're not sneaking up on people. But it's a matter to know that in your head, but play that way in your heart. And I think that's what they're struggling with this year.
Well, this team's a little different than the last six teams that the Spurs have played. They have a little better record than all six of those teams. And they got the horses over there that if the game is close, they can win it. Eddie Johnson, Dale Ellis, these guys have won many, many NBA games just finishing all by themselves. And so, you know, this is a team to be reckoned with. They've beat a lot of good teams in the league. They've had their struggles. They've been struggling with injuries. Dale Ellis is just coming back into form. Then they, of course, had the adjustment when Eddie Johnson and Xavier McDaniel, that trade. But they got a lot of talent. They don't really have the huge center, but they play really hard. And, you know, they're capable of beating anybody.
They have shown that in this first half. 58% from the field and 12 of 21 from outside have fallen for the Sonics. Spurs only 7 of 21 from outside. Theirs has been an inside game. Sonics have been able to go both ways. And again, the Spurs crowd them. One on the shot clock as Cage misses. Another offensive rebound and a rejection by Robinson of McKee. But another offensive board. 11 offensive, 10 defensive rebounds by Seattle. And there's another one in Cage, partially deflected by the Admiral. Out of bounds, they say, off David. Jack Neese is going to get an argument from Robinson here.
Well, here's Michael Cage putting it up. A little short, gets his own rebound, puts it up. There's an inordinate number of left-handers on this team. Derek McKee shoots the ball as well left-handed in the lane as he does right. That's what I think was special about that block David Robinson just put down, was that McKee put it up left-handed and David picked it off anyway.
Well, he had an argument that replay showed it off McKee, and then he fouls McKee here. His first team second. Sean Kemp in for Eddie Johnson. And he was stout in the first quarter, but he's a welcome sight just because he gets this man off the floor. Eddie Johnson, 9 for 11, 19 first half points off the bench. If they get a shot off, it'll be their fifth attempt this possession, and Payton gets it, not there, tapped again, and it won't go. They call that goaltending. They got six cracks at it. They still came away empty.
Goaltending. Here's Gary Payton floating one up over David Robinson. And it looked like...
Not even close.
Yeah, it looked like, I thought they called McKee over the back on the rebound, but that wasn't even close to an offensive goaltending.
Fall away, Terry Cummings. And they're back within three with a minute and a half in the half. 53-50 game, a game effort by Pressey to keep that one alive along the sideline. David Greenwood to replace Terry Cummings.
That was a smart play that time by Paul Pressey as Willie Anderson picked Dale Ellis up about 35 feet from the basket, and then he has his back turned. Paul Pressey came over there, tried to double team, steal the ball.
Ellis out against Anderson. They have to go it alone. Nope, they're going to get the over the back by Elliott on McKee. That is three on Sean Elliott. Left side of your screen, you'll pick it up right here.
Well, here's Sean Elliott once again hammering in deep, this time with Derek McKee, and ends up getting the foul call on him again. Just can't get a break tonight.
That has been just about a standoff. Elliott's got three, McKee only two, and he leads them with 16.7 per game. Non-factor so far. Here's Sidney Green in, replacing Elliott after that third foul. Eric McKee really benefiting from that trade, sending McDaniel from Seattle to Phoenix, opening up some of the area he likes to operate in. Anderson spotted an opening, finger roll comes up short. Spurs got within three. Now Seattle ball up five in the final minute of the half. Payton waiting for Ellis to pop off on the key screen, and he finally does. Now the two-man game, McKee turns on Greenwood. Help comes from Robinson, shot clock down to one, and they don't get it off. That's the best help defense by the Spurs in the half, and they force the violation.
Spurs ball!
Willie Anderson, most of the half, has been the Spurs offense. A three-pointer by Pressey, not there. One chance only. Kemp off to Payton. And Cage, who's hit the outside shot all half long. He's got eight. On his 29th birthday, he's having a good time. 57-50. And the Spurs will use their 22nd timeout. Speaking of birthdays, we have to get it in. Dual birthday celebrations in the Spurs family days. Assistant coach Greg Popovich turning 29, he tells us. And that man, general manager Bob Bass, turning 39, he tells us. Happy birthday to both.
So that's what all that chocolate cake in the media room is all about.
If we don't get it, as you have noticed, just for no reason at all. Our next HSE telecast will come your way Tuesday, February 5th at 7:30. The Spurs will host all-star starter Chris Mullin and the Golden State Warriors here at Hemisphere Arena. Spurs are on the road tomorrow at Houston. That's a 6:30 radio pregame start, 7 o'clock on TNT for the national cable cast. Final instructions from Larry Brown. The shot clock is at 16. The game clock is at 18.3. And it's 57-50 Seattle. Not that different from the first meeting this year. Spurs had to come from behind and play some of their best defense of the year, holding them to 14 in the fourth quarter to win. Rod Strickland against Payton. Everybody else spreads out. The shot clock at 7. And it's Pressey to Robinson. Halfway down. Pressey tried to tap it. Robinson's follow not there. And that will end the first half. Well, we saw one Sonic possession where they had six tries at it. Almost that many for the Spurs. And they come up empty. And Brown's worst fears being realized here. This athletic, talented Casey Jones-led Sonic team leading 57-50 at intermission on HSE.
We Brits are learning your American football.
50, not 19, a statistical change, 15. Eddie Johnson points in the first half as they led by two at the end of one, stretch it out to as much as 9 and by 7 here. Well, Thursday night, Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls visit Hemisphere Arena. The NBA scoring leader, Jordan, 31 points per game, but did you know that he was cut from his high school basketball team? Here's tonight's NBA halftime feature.
Bounds pass comes into Jordan. Here's Michael at the foul line. A shot on Elo. Good! The Bulls win it! They win!
I beat Michael Jordan out in 10th grade for the varsity. I made it, and he got cut.
Yes, I'm the coach who cut Michael as a sophomore.
And I told him to go into math. That's where the money was.
Even though he didn't become a mathematician, Michael's basketball numbers have brought about plenty of fame and fortune. But the road to success has not been as easy as it might appear at first blush. In fact, portraits of this NBA artist as a young man hardly revealed him to be the basketball player most likely to succeed.
So my friend and I, Leroy Smith, who was about 6'7 at the time, and I was maybe 5'9½, we said we were going to try out for the varsity team just to see what happens. And because of Leroy's height, I got the short end of the stick, I felt, and he made the varsity, and I got cut.
I was big, okay? And when you're 6'8", you play basketball because you're tall. So that way it wasn't because I was talented, I was just 6'8". You know, 6'8", if I say, hey, you gotta play basketball for us. And why look at it, you know, he should have played varsity because he was a talent in the 10th grade.
Today, of course, Michael is one of the most recognizable athletes in the world. But on those rare occasions when Jordan manages to go incognito, he likes to pay special tribute to the player who beat him out.
So when I'm out meeting people,
at all. I think he wanted a little more fire out of his team, especially late first quarter, early second quarter. They started to do it, but they need to do it for the whole final 24 minutes, don't you think?
Well, they got a lot of fire. Willie Anderson has really come to play tonight. Terry Cummings really come to play tonight. They just, Seattle is a very difficult team. I mean, we were talking about these kind of things here, reversing an offensive rebounding story, stopping Eddie Johnson. Well, those things two work together. As Eddie Johnson has a great night, defensive people have to come and help. That means that the rebounding assignments change. Shooting better from the free throw line, they're just walking up there and bouncing in and missing the first one, making the second one. That's sort of rough on you. You just got to concentrate a little bit more.
57-50 our halftime score, and tonight's Miller Genuine Draft trivia question goes all the way back to the inaugural season in Seattle, 67-68. Who led the team in scoring that year? We'll have the answer when we come back. Season 67-68, the leading scorer that year, Walt Hazard at 24 points per game. Later would be UCLA head coach. Tonight's trivia question brought to you by Miller Genuine Draft. Our first half highlights, a dunkathon here, beginning with a nice pick and roll from Gary Payton to Sean Kemp. And continuing with David Robinson's answer to Sean Kemp. Kemp got him early with two or three of those. Finally, Robinson followed him up, and following up the miss here, Derek McKee, once up, twice, and down. Willie Anderson for the Spurs, their leading scorer with 15, right through the middle. Eddie Johnson will flop, get the foul call right there, and Sean Elliott will eventually get a technical foul call. And the first half numbers show edges really across the board for the Sonics, 53% to 47% from the field. Spurs only 5 of 10 at the line, out rebounded by 5. Two more Seattle turnovers, 7 more blocks by the Spurs. And Cummings with some final words trying to influence one of the young Spurs, Sean Elliott. Larry Brown discussed this before the game. This is one of the hidden values of a guy like TC.
What's difficult for Terry Cummings is if he's not personally feeling good and playing well, it's difficult for him to do what he just did then, which is give some few words of encouragement to Sean Elliott.
Which is a funny kind of a point, because it's almost like if he's not playing well, his analysis means less, which is illogical and ridiculous.
No, he's not. He's just focused on, you know, just trying to get his game going.
Bill Ellis, rejection, Robinson. Cummings to push to Elliott. He had Robinson underneath, stop and go move against McKee. They will, I believe, get McKee out in the lane. That is his first foul. Here's second
Sean,
foul.
Sean makes a nice dribble through his legs and takes the ball to the hoop and draws the foul. First foul of the third quarter.
All set up by Robinson's fifth block of the night. Pick and roll. David with a long step in. 12 points to make it 57-52. Robinson, the Spur rebounding leader with 6. McKee is the Sonic leader with 6. Here's Michael Cage. Several key outside shots in the first half. Payton yet to score. The turnaround right in the face of Elliott. And McKee showing that he may be a little more active this half. In a hurry to answer, Rod Strickland right through the middle. Spurs have done that twice, and Ellis able to answer right back with English on the backhand reverse.
Well, we talked about athleticism. We have seen some athletic plays to start this second half.
61-54. Robinson taking it up on Cage, who lands on him. Sonics have passed the fouls around real well. They have no one with more than 2. Ellis at the other end. Watch this again.
David goes to the line.
That's just great control and very clever guy. I mean, he knows better than to try to take it up over David Robinson. But he, as he took the ball strong to the hoop, he gave David every impression that he would go on the strong side. He just ducked under him and rolled it in on the weak side.
That's the first time a Spur has made both free throws. Baden, who wears number two for several reasons, throws it away. Anderson, two on one. Strickland looks off to Willie and then takes it himself. 3-point game. This is where the Spurs are at their best, getting their offense off of their defense. And almost a turnover for Cage. It goes for the first bucket tonight by Gary Payton. And then traveling on Anderson. Ellis had planted himself, wanted to get an offensive foul on Willie, and instead he got the traveling call.
Well, we saw Gary Payton do this in the first half, trying to stop the guy with the ball. The Spurs advanced the ball on their fast break off the dribble, general. The outlet pass usually going to a guard. That time, Dale Ellis did a smart play and picked up Willie Anderson just as he got the ball.
Drew really banged Ellis around between the picks, so he goes the other way, and it's Kemp from 15. His first point since the first quarter. Now Kemp holding off Robinson to no avail, and David misses the wide open lay-in. Long pass, Ellis takes it in on Anderson. And that really hurts when you get a wide open shot the way Robinson did, and it turns into the quick two the other way, and they're right back up by nine. Anderson trying to make Ellis work hard on the defensive end and counted with a foul. 17 for Willie.
Willie Anderson gets the ball in the low block and immediately spins around Dale Ellis, who doesn't guard that baseline like any good high school coach will tell you. And ends up getting the bump foul and gives up a potential 3-point play.
18 for Willie. Foul is Ellis's second, 67-61. Gary Payton, the number two pick in the draft. The number two all-time assistant steal man in the NCAA. And jersey number two, Ellis, symbolic three-point champion, wearing number three. On the line, a long two, and it's short for Payton, knocked around to Anderson. Sonics quicker back defensively this time. And it's Cummings, overpowering Dale Ellis, too much off the glass, one more chance. Coming down with it out of bounds was Payton, it'll be Spurs ball. There are no weak points to go at. Either way, there is a good athlete, a guy who can run, jump, do everything you need to play basketball, all 10 positions on the floor right now.
Yeah, and they're really playing, you know, we were talking with Eddie Johnson in the piece on at halftime here. They're playing in a lot of control for a road game. They're playing with a lot of maturity. I think Eddie Johnson's first half just gave him a lot of confidence, and everybody's picked it up a notch, and they're really playing well.
Good look down the baseline, Elliott to Cummings. 67-63, a dozen for TC. Spurs need a stop at the other end. McKee hounded by Elliott. Payton with a Kemp screen goes around it. Cage again from 15. Every point he's got in this game has been from outside. And they'll get Payton for the deep backcourt foul, his second, fourth on the team. These two teams met in November. He was challenging Alvin Robertson for the steals leadership in the NBA. He's since fallen out of the top 10, but well, he's got the tools. Once he really gets a feel for the NBA to be up there every year. Anderson fearlessly through traffic, got his own rebound away from Cage and McKee. Cage rejects him. One more chance, it won't go. Cummings for the follow.
Well, really hard work there by Willie Anderson.
Boy, they saw what the Sonics did in the first half and they raised the ante. This will be over the back on Robinson, his second. And the jalapeno stacking up for Cummings. That's seven rebounds so far. Now, wait a minute. That's 8 rebounds. They're more lenient than the official stat crew. And Dave Robinson says, take a jalapeno down. Inbounds Ellis. Robinson for the board. His 7th of the game. Cummings for the pull-up. Got it. 2-point Seattle lead at margin at 69-67. And Casey Jones a little bit nervous on the Seattle bench. Cage, not the best ball handler in the league. A long 2, short for Kemp. Robinson showing the ball handling ability, and then turns it over as Payton is fouled by Willie Anderson.
Spurs, foul call number 40.
And we'll have a spur timeout. Robinson electing not to immediately find the outlet man, and it costs him a turnover.
It's time for more basketball.
Nice little run working for the Spurs. The Seattle front line, with the exception of McKee, very difficult to deal with all night. And it's 69-67 with this Spur charge of 9-2. 6.5 minute mark, quarter number 3. Shot clock at 7. Ellis dumped down low. McKee throws up an air ball. Cummings ahead. Willie Anderson with Ellis to beat, and he'll beat it. Tie game. First tie since early second period at 36 all. Cage finally with a miss. Knocked around to Kemp, and Sean Kemp making sure.
What a strong play by Sean Kemp.
And by Strickland at the other end, and he'll go to the line on the foul by Cage. His 3rd, 5th against the team. Nate McMillan checking in, replacing Payton, and one more look at the power of this 21-year-old, Sean Kemp. In just a moment. First of all, Strickland at the line.
Shaking his head. Just rattled that ball, hit the rim 3 or 4 times for it, fella.
Hey, tonight they take him any way they fall. Technical malfunction on the replay of the Kemp dunk. Maybe later. 71 all. Ellis, a step on Anderson. That's usually all he needs. Spurs now limiting Seattle to 1. Traveling on Strickland.
I was going to say, on the play before, we didn't get a replay of that, but he hopped and skipped a little bit as he took that ball to the hoop. That time, Mike Mathis was right behind him and caught him shifting the ball as he looked like he was going to try and get rid of it. Quick feet. It's hard to catch him traveling.
McKee turns on Elliott. That's his favorite move. Lean in, go back out. Knocked around. He'll get his own miss. Traveling Seattle. So they return the favor. 4th Sonic turnover in the first 7 minutes of this half. Elliott against Kemp. And Sean Kemp made that an almost impossible shot, chased down by Cage. Kemp quick enough to hold off Elliott and big enough to be right there in his face, and not the same when the matchup is reversed. Elliott not big enough to deal with Kemp, so they call him for the foul from behind, and that's his 4th.
It's his 4th, 3rd team foul.
He'll come out. David Greenwood will check in. And Sean with a rough night, only 3 points. That on a 3-point basket. Led the Spurs in the first meeting at 27 back in November at Seattle. Here's the man to watch. Johnson replacing Kemp. Eddie Johnson, 7 of 9, 15 first half points. And they put him on Robinson. He missed the fall away. And Strickland there for the rebound. 4-on-2 charge. And Cage stripping Cummings. They had McMillan in front and Cage behind. And the foul is on Nate McMillan. His 1st.
His 1st.
Very pretty good fast break. Strickland waiting for Terry Cummings to catch up. There was nothing that Cage could do but foul Terry as he took his ball to the hoop.
Really hard to believe he had not led this team in scoring since December 5th, but he hadn't until Saturday. Pressy in for Anderson. Willie's having a hard working night. He has chased Dale Ellis all over the floor, outscored him 20-12 so far, and the Spurs remain perfect this half at the line. They've got their first lead since 2:24 to go in the first period when it was 25-24. Now Ellis has Pressy to deal with. Robinson on the key and Strickland on McMillan. Ellis with room. Not there from three-point land, and the finger roll followed by the Cages there. He's got 12. NBA rebounding leader 3 years ago. Michael Cage the last forward to do that. Underneath, and another Seattle foul. They're really having to rack him up now, and a blow to the nose from the key this time. That is his third.
Takes quite a bit of a shot on the way down, and David was trying to say sorry about that after it happened. It was just an accident.
Had to shake it off and get Kemp back in.
David Robinson.
It is not the place to be when Robinson's in the neighborhood. 15 for David. Breaks the tie, Spurs by two. Now near the 4 minute mark of the third. Easily the best of the first three quarters from the Spurs perspective. Johnson double. Missed by Kemp, Strickland there. Sonics missing some of those open shots this quarter. Right back to him, Anderson to Strickland. The rocket gets him up. 4-point game. He's got 8 of his 10 this quarter. And an offensive foul drawn by Anderson on Nate McMillan.
Here's Willie switching off to help Paul Pressy and draws the charge right there in the lane.
19-6 San Antonio run over a 6 minute margin. Running banker comes up short for Strickland. And this time the Sonics push it up, and Eddie Johnson on the run for his 17th point.
Now Willie Anderson and Paul Pressy had their hands full guarding Eddie Johnson and Dale Ellis, two of the great scorers in this league.
Oh, that's a great play by McMillan. Robinson was going to jam. He's fouled as he turns into Sean Kemp, but that would have lifted the roof off this building had the original strip not have occurred. It's the only way they were going to prevent Robinson from rattling the rim.
Well, you really got to be impressed with that guy right there, Sean Kemp. At his age, he's just played a fearless basketball game, playing big guys, playing little guys, taking the ball to the hoop.
Sonics get Olden Polonies in. Cage gets a breather. They still have not missed from the stripe in the third quarter. 16 for 21 now for the game. Seattle only 5 for 7. And a miss by Ellis. Rebound Anderson. 4-on-2. Willie thinking all the way. Then he spots Paul Pressy for the finger roll. First bucket in a couple of games for Press, and the Spurs have their big lead of the night. And a KC Jones tie with a standing ovation.
Why should you buy from Smith Chevrolet?
Tonight's San Antonio's first telecast brought to you in part by True Value Hardware. Got a tough job to do? You can do it with True Value Hardware stores. 2 minutes, 40 seconds in the third period. It is 31-18 since halftime. The Spurs have their big lead of the night at 81-75. Sedale threed in off the bench. Streak shooter can get them ignited if he's on. Eddie Johnson streaking in the first half, nothing in the second half. Spurs again run it. Strickland all the way, and he'll go to the line. Where he really gives the body up. Takes a lot of punishment to play his style of basketball.
Well, he was waiting for somebody. He couldn't find anybody on the left wing. He finally just takes it all the way as McMillan doesn't commit to guard him until the last second. Draws the foul.
Rocket those in the line. Shoots two.
Tell you what, in addition to those numbers, he's got six rebounds. He can halfway be thinking about a triple-double tonight. 82-75. This is a 17-point swing. Sonics led by as many as nine. Now it's the Spurs by eight. Sonics are three for their last 12 from the field. They've lived and died by the jumper here in the third. Mainly died. Johnson in traffic. Three Spurs around him, still got it.
2 minutes. 2 minutes and a quarter.
Come on, baby.
Strickland looking. Somehow he spotted Anderson. Willie with 22. One of his top three or four games all year with a quarter to go. And the Spurs have hit their last six field goal attempts. Sean Kemp comes up short. And Greenwood is there. Kobe, these shots were all falling for Seattle in the first half. They get a steal here from McMillan. Two on one. Paulides had a good hard foul. Greenwood, he's going to check and make sure Paulides is okay.
That's smart foul by David Greenwood to put Olden Paulides on the line, make these two a little more difficult to get to. That was a dunk coming up there.
Well, if you're Casey Jones, as you see Robinson replaced by Terry Cummings, it's frustrating to see your team get the same shots and just not do the same thing with them.
Well, you know, we were talking again, once again, with Eddie Johnson at halftime. He's talking about the inexperience of this team. It's going to be guys like Eddie Johnson and Dale Ellis that carry them through when the crowd gets into it like this on somebody's home court. They're sort of letting this one get away from them.
So they slap the full court pressure on, and they say Greenwood commits the offensive foul, stepping between Kemp and Paulides.
Well, they put a really good trap on in the corner, and as David Greenwood stepped through the trap right here, he just shoulders Paulides out of the way. Paulides makes a nice flop there and draws the foul.
Two on David. Sean Higgins in for the first time. Final minute 23 of the quarter. Strickland resting. Three to mismatch against Greenwood. Out to McMillan. And this time the offensive foul will go the other way. Eddie Johnson for hooking Cressy. His third.
Well, he tries to step in front of Cressy right there and throws his arm up. Cressy does a pretty good job of letting the official know that he got hit.
Well, it's that lame beer factor.
Well, it works.
Like
it works.
Cancer all over the league. Cummings on the left-hander. Paulides the rebound. Under a minute we go in the third. This has been the Spurs' turnaround period, which they needed. McMillan baseline, open, long two, not there for Eddie Johnson. Running rebound, Anderson. And what a night he has had. Stripped by McMillan, he'll get it back if he can pick it up. And he'll work some time off the clock. All alone, Paul Cressy. Anderson with his sixth assist of the game. And the lead is nine. That's the big margin for the Spurs. Paulides wanted that one in the low block. And a nice tightrope save by Cressy. Spurs work with 10 seconds for the last shot. And Anderson with the feeling. Not this time, and Eddie Johnson at the buzzer will not get it off in time. But the Spurs a completely different team in that third quarter. Seven down at the half and nine up as we head to the fourth on HSE. Southwest Airlines game summary. What a turnaround of the third quarter. 55%, Sonics 38%. Willie Anderson all around tonight has been the jewel for the Spurs, and on second chance points, at least they slowed it down. That's how Seattle built their big lead, and they only had 5 second chance points in that third quarter. It is Willie's night, 22. This is his fifth 20-point game of the year. Something about the Sonics gets him going. He averaged 19 against them last year. 18 in the first meeting this year. He can think about 30 if he keeps going this night. Full court pressure. Cummings with a quick timeout call. He could not find anybody to throw it into, and Knees is going to disallow the timeout. Says he didn't call it in time, and that's a turnover. I don't know if I've ever seen that on the opening inbounds pass of the fourth quarter.
Well, Seattle needs to do something to change the complex of the game. They also have to get their big horses, Dale Ellis, fired up. It's three sets of moving pick to try to free Ellis. Gets called for it. But this is very similar to what happened in the game up in Seattle, where the Spurs, Seattle sort of controlled the first part of the game, and then they, as the Spurs up the ante on defense, as Seattle folded.
So an exchange of turnovers, open shot comes up short for Higgins. And Nate McMillan, veteran from North Carolina State, moving in as the backup to Peyton this year at the point. McKee, Polonese turns in the lane. Seven for the veteran from Virginia. And another takeaway in the backcourt. Aaron McKee, and they'll say the foul after the steal was on Cumming. That's his third.
Once again, pressure in the backcourt bothers the Spurs, as he probably got the ball in the wrong guy's hands. Terry Cummings is a good ball handler, but he's going up against Derek McKee, who's an excellent defender and great quickness for his size.
Reflex grab by Terry. 15th Spur turnover. Alley-oop, too much for McKee. And either Greenwood or Cummings will put him on the line here. This will again be on, well, they're going to say Greenwood this time. That's his third.
David Robinson in for GC.
Robinson in to replace Cummings. Another good solid night for TC. 18 points, 8 boards so far. 8 of 12 from the field. And that's really where you can tell when Terry's back feels good. The shooting percentage was in the 30s when he was injured. He took time off, came back 12 of 18 Saturday, and 8 for 12 so far here. 87-82, and again, lots of pressure. Strickland dribbling into a trap, and he's bailed out by Sean Higgins just in time. Strong move to the hoop, and the left-hand flip by Paul Pressey.
Once they broke down the press, they ended up with the pretty easy shot as Paul Pressey takes the ball to the hoop left-handed. But, boy, there's some precarious passes against that press.
Loose ball foul will go on Polonese. First of the game on Polonese.
Here's David Robinson coming to help as Ellis takes the ball to the hoop. Polonese takes advantage of it, tries to come up with an offensive rebound, but goes over the back.
Robinson to screen, Polonese to switch, and they double the ball. And they take it away. Then off Strickland to three. Back to Polonese. Rolls it home. Sonics open this fourth quarter with a flurry of takeaways, and they're within five. They outscore the Spurs after turnovers, 20-13 in this game. Almost another one for three. And then Elliott is fouled by Garrett McKee. That'll be his fourth. McKee, the first Sonic with four. With the Spurs, only Sean Elliott has four. He's got one more foul than Quaint tonight. Good look at Sean. Study and concentration. That, the first missed free throw of this half by the Spurs. That was as big a key as any in a third quarter turnaround. Not missing at the line. Elliott over Pressey, gave him room. Couldn't take advantage. Running rebound, Elliott. But he's one on four. And fouled. Kind of a needless foul over there by Ellis. Not even really going for the ball. That's his third.
I think as Sean dribbles down and Seattle comes to double team really quick. And one of the things that Seattle does here is Strickland was talking to the official about getting grabbed when he was in the double team just a minute ago.
Robinson.
Boy, Polynes just really got away with knocking David Robinson off the block.
Greenwood. Rattled it in. Seven, and a nice effort off the bench tonight for David Greenwood.
Well, he looked around for everybody to throw the ball to and decided I might as well shoot it.
McKee hitting the deck this time. And this will be four on Greenwood. We think it's been physical so far, multiplied by about three from this point until the end. Bird on the team. Sedale three, replacing Dale Ellis for Seattle. Spurs won three of the four meetings last year, trying to make it two for two this year. Three from the circle, count it. And they're going to say Robinson got him on the elbow. And this is one that he'd love to have back.
Sedale three comes off this pick right here. Puts it up and looks like David reached out and did touch him.
Well, grazing is touching, I guess, technically, but there's no way that he affected the shot or else Street would not have made the shot.
Well, from where the official was, he had the perfect angle to see that.
9-3, 92-87. Pace is really slow in the fourth quarter. We're going to bang it out. Court affair, offensive foul. This might be five on Elliott.
32 on Sean Elliott.
It is.
Fifth, no team foul.
And Sean will have to come out. Terry Cummings,
his
replacement. Frustrating night for the second man from Arizona.
He's gotten his money's worth. He's been in there banging folks all night.
McKee turns immediately on Cummings. And the Robinson rebound. Somebody slapping at that one, and then Cummings with a sore thumb as Robinson rejects Kemp, and it's out of bounds to the Spurs, and Cummings still trying to shake it off. Whatever happened to him will be checked by trainer John Anderson, and that'll be a full Spurs timeout. 8 minutes, 39 seconds, quarter number four in a five-point game.
With a bigger box than Ford.
And then back here on HSE on Tuesday, February 5th against the Golden State Warriors. 92-87.
Seattle still in this full court press, trying to put as much pressure on the Spurs as they can.
And this time, the ball in the right man's hands. Rod Strickland. Spurs turned it over when forwards tried to handle it. Underneath, Cummings powers it home. He's got 20. The 11th 20-point game this year for Cummings, and the lead is 7. But the pace not really conducive to Seattle-style basketball. This is not what they do best, pounded out in the half court. Spurs shooting much better, taking it away, Willie Anderson. Well, that's got the Sonics on their heels. Dump underneath, two more. Back to the 9-point big lead of the game, 96-87. Jones ready to get Ellis back in. He needs somebody to take off. Here's a long one for three. His 11th. Best year of Sadale Threet's career. He's up over 13 points per game. They go to the trap. No problem. Greenwood a little extra on that one, and it wouldn't stay down. Too bad. It might have gotten him on the highlight film. Threet the other corner this time. Rebound Polony. Strip Strickland. The Rocket to the Admiral.
Well, just an explosive transition game right now from the Spurs. Seattle's going to have to talk about this one.
22nd Sonic timeout as Hemisphere Arena stands to applaud David Robinson. Perfectly timed feed in the open court by Strickland. And 20 for the Admiral. 98-89. Let's check the rest of the NBA this evening. Final scores in the East. Detroit by six at home against Washington. Boston, after their loss at the Lakers' expense yesterday, or at their expense against the Lakers at Boston, on the road, they win at Minnesota, 108-87. Spurs trying to make it five in a row and seven straight Seattle road losses here. Getting closer, but still some work to be done. Ellis McKee, Kemp Polonese, and three for Casey Jones. Shot clock down to three. Not even close to a shot with one. Three. Strickland made a miss. McKee got the rebound. That's a season high eighth offensive rebound, and he's fouled, and that might be five on Greenwood.
An opportunistic long rebound by Derek McKee and ends up getting fouled there by David. He thought he got all ball and he brought his hands down. The official called that from about 35 feet. So David loses on that one.
All five of these Greenwood fouls have been since halftime. And real unusual for a veteran because normally he knows when he's going to be called for a foul or when he's borderline, and he's not going to roll up five and a half. Replaced by Sidney Green as Derek McKee goes to double figures. And a 22nd San Antonio timeout. 6 minutes and 48 seconds. This copyrighted program presented by the authority of HSE, the NBA, and the San Antonio Spurs, and is intended solely for the non-commercial use of our audience. Any publication or reproduction or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written permission of the NBA, Spurs, and HSE is prohibited. Quick check of the HEB hustle board. Spurs by two on the board. Sonics five more steals. Spurs eight more blocks. And 57-52 when you total them all up.
Well, that last time, Sidney Green had a difficult time finding Rod Strickland. There's sort of two theories on presses. One is to get the ball in really quick so that the other team can't set up. The other is to get all your people, let the ball roll until you get all your people in the right position where you know where your guys are and then work from there. Once again, another turnover created by Seattle.
Do it where nobody was. If Seattle gets back in this thing and they're only seven down, that has to be their recipe. Make the Spurs help him out. Kemp turned away that time. Four to shoot. Ellis just enough room, and it will get lodged between backboard and rim, and that's a jump ball.
Well, we're seeing a Dale Ellis is just not as sharp as he's been. Just not rounded into form yet. But normally he just buries those shots, especially in the fourth quarter.
Well, you really have to take advantage when he's this cold. He's 4 for 16. Kemp only 6 of 15. McKee only 2 of 11. And this half, Eddie Johnson not nearly the factor he was in the first half, and not even in the game right now. Gary Payton is. He replaces three. Does that surprise you that they have not really called on Johnson this half that much?
Well, yeah, it does. I mean, he was so effective in the first half.
A missed jump. They'll do it again. Robinson and Kemp.
I guess just in terms of the matchup, though, I don't know how they, where, who they would take out, you know.
Underneath it goes to Kemp, and it will be a three-point opportunity for Sean Kemp. Spurs were hoping for a traveling call. Looked like some baby steps by Kemp.
So this is a weak side rebound foul. I don't know. I don't see how that could be a foul, but this is Sean Kemp working real hard against David Robinson. He's unorthodox players, left-handed, pumped with the left and went with the right hand. David sort of backed off. I'm not sure how Sidney Green factored into that.
Here's the man he fouled, and Polonese puts it in.
Seattle also uses their center as the front guy on the press. Olden Polonese is very active and gets a lot of long arms up there on that first pass.
Sonics have cut it to four, halfway mark, quarter number four. Spurs have had several 9-point leads. The Sonics can come within two after the miss by Cummings. And Polonese threw it too low for Ellis, a case of the wrong man handling the ball in the open court. Olden Polonese a little bit out of his element. Timeout, 5:47 to play. And the Spurs clinging to a 4-point advantage. Time now for L.A. Gear, unstoppable player of the game, and he's Willie Anderson, 10 of 19, 22.7 assists, 5 rebounds, the most emphatic 2 of the night for Willie right there. L.A. Gear, unstoppable player of the game. Spurs again have pressure to deal with, 5:43 to play, down by 4, Anderson beats the pressure, Robinson in the middle, Greenwood back in with the 5 foul. And Cummings goes baseline for the tough reverse. Oh, he had Polonese, McKee, and Kemp all nearby. 24 for Terry. 50 in the last two games. He really has returned. McKee surrounded, gets the 2.
Well, they had 2 back picks there in the lane. They came down and back picked, and then they reversed it and back picked again and ended up with the mismatch.
Sonics again within 4. McKee against Cummings. Rod Strickland comes up short, got his own board. He has that knack. He got blocked from behind by Polonese and tried to flip it around to Greenwood, but it's knocked out of bounds by Seattle.
Well, most guards would have gotten that offensive rebound and brought it out. Rod immediately turned back and went back into the traffic, trying to make something happen.
Oh, Robinson wide open. They see him, but now Polonese on him. Takes him in anyway. Too hard. Rebound off Cummings. And taken by Payton. They can come within 2, maybe 1. 4.5 minutes remaining. Dale Ellis wants it. Payton looking elsewhere. It's Kemp. Shot clock at 4. Another long Seattle possession. Polonese at the buzzer.
Well, they seemed really confused about what they wanted to do. I think Ellis was calling for one play. Gary Payton had the ball, so he was in charge. Least likely guy got the ball and made the shot.
They've got a 9-2 run, and they foul Anderson. Dale Ellis is 4th. Fourth against the team. Ellis and McKee, the only Sonics in trouble, have each got 4. Non-shooting foul. Anderson ready to throw it in.
First ball.
And here's Greenwood. Spots the opening. Rims it out. And a Sonic chance to tie with 3:50 to play. A lot of people in this building thought it was over when the Spurs were up by 9. It was anything but over. Payton on the runner, comes up short, rebound Polonese, and the follow is good, and it's 100-100. Olden Polonese with 9 of his 14 in the fourth quarter. Pressey turns it over.
Polonese knocked that one loose.
Gary Payton's alley-oop too tall, and they say it's goaltended by Derek McKee.
Boy, I'm not sure about this call either. Gary Payton lobbed this pass up there.
I think that's the second phantom goaltend we've seen tonight against Seattle.
But it didn't look like it was over the rim when he touched it.
A little closer to the last one, but that angle pretty clearly showed he was not in the cylinder. Spurs get a break. Cressy to break the tie, tied up instead, and Sean Kemp throwing the big body block underneath.
Sean Kemp moving his feet on defense pretty good. Cuts off the baseline, and as Paul didn't have anywhere to go with it, tries to put it up, and Sean Kemp takes it away. Jump ball.
And one by Robinson takes it right in. That's as big a basket as we've seen in this game. It looked like a big advantage on the jump to Seattle. Spurs steal two to lead by two. Payton into traffic ties it again.
Boy, what a play by Gary Payton as he takes the ball through the seam and throws it up on the glass.
And Ellis playing free safety to knock it away from Anderson. Boy, just the second basket of the game by Gary Payton, and he picks a spot down the stretch to tie it up. The type of player he was known as at Oregon State. Great trash talker, fearless, didn't matter what was happening. He would take command of the game, regardless of the time, regardless of the score. Anderson, tough runner off the glass. The key was beating Ellis on the quick first step. Ellis for three, way short, rebound Robinson, and Dale Ellis, 4 for 17. Anderson at the other end. Play of the game. This may very well be the game deciding play here. It pushed the Spurs up by four. Look at the body control by Willie Anderson. Wraps himself around Dale Ellis, and then from the slam, Cam high off the glass and rattles it in for our Amalie Oil play of the game. It makes it 106 to 102. It gives Willie a 26-point night. All around, it may be his best game of the year. Still 2:08 remaining. He's within one of his season high of 27 points. Defense is what they're concentrating on here, with McKee ready to inbound it against Pressy, who's got his back turned.
Still surprised we haven't seen Eddie Johnson in this portion of his game.
I'm shocked we haven't seen. We haven't seen him much at all in the fourth quarter period.
Especially as much as Dale Ellis has struggled.
You can't throw it in the ocean. Deep in the corner, the miss by Kemp, batted around to Greenwood. Spurs run, Anderson with the breakaway jam. Might be enough. Sonics will go to the line. They went underneath to Kemp. Let's see, it will be on either Anderson or Robinson. And number four on the Admiral.
Here we got Willie finishing the fast break. Once again, we get the upstairs view of that play.
And Sean Kemp, only a 68% free throw shooter, missing. This is a not up to NBA par free throw shooting team, Seattle. They do put on the pressure again, and the Spurs break it again. Lead pass chased down by Strickland. Wisely will pull it out with a minute 31. And extend the possession as long as they can. Shot clock at 10. Strickland ready to go to work on the rookie, and Payton puts him on the line. His third, fifth against the team. Bonus in effect both ways.
That was an interesting... A little bit of confusion there by the Spurs is Rod Strickland was calling four, and two of the other Spurs, Pressy and Dave Robinson, had their fists going for the fist play.
usual, the guy with the ball won. And at last, we see Eddie Johnson in for Kemp. Eddie Johnson with 7 of 9 from the field, 15 points in the first half, 4 in the second half on 2 of 5.
Just sort of surprising substitution to get Eddie Johnson in at this late juncture. I mean, really, we're talking about kicking field goals here now, coming cold off the bench, shooting 3 pointers.
We have a timeout. Next to last timeout for Seattle. Rod Strickland with his 4th straight double-double, but Willie Anderson, the story, with a season high, 28 points. And the Spurs on top, 110-103, with a minute 22 remaining. Good news for the Miami Heat. They have welcomed Ronnie Cicely back to the active roster, activated from the injured list. Kurt Rambis on the injured list, and that gave the Phoenix Suns room to sign Joe Barry Carroll. And all the ingredients were there. Spurs were hitting the shots. That kept Seattle from running. It made it easy to rebound for the Spurs, and they really carried that over into the fourth quarter. Sonics have not really hurt him in the running game. It's been a matter of takeaways, keeping them as close as 7 points. Another sold-out house, 15,908. Business with 1:22 to play. Keep in mind the 3-point threats of Johnson and Ellis. And Ellis just cannot buy one. Offensive board, McKee, put back goes. 8 of his 14 here in the fourth period, 110-105. All they need is a couple more steals. And they're right there. 1 minute mark.
Now we got the fist bump.
And it's Strickland. The mismatch against McKee. Shot clock at 5. And Living on the run. It will not go. Foul number 5 on McKee.
Rod got Derek McKee switched off on him, and he told that he asked, you can see him right here. I don't know if you see it and see it. He nodded to get Paul Pressey to clear, and he just took McKee off the dribble.
And then Olden Polonese may have had a spur step on his foot. He limped off the floor and was replaced by Sean Kemp. Double-double for Rod tonight, his 10th of the year, 4th consecutive. 2 rebounds from a triple-double as they work on Polonese. 111-105. Ages still to go, 45 seconds. 3 all the way in, knocked out. Big rebound by Strickland. 3-on-1, they'll take Paul Pressey for the slam dunk. Long pass down to Eddie Johnson. Spurs had an option there, use time or get the quick shot. They got the quick jam by Paul Pressey. 8-point lead looks good with 27 seconds.
Here's the way a fast break runs, is Willie Anderson. What you don't see is David Robinson clearing the side. Ellis had to pay attention to David Robinson as he came through. That left Paul Pressey on the weak side, and Willie Anderson got the good pass to him.
And then Pressey fouling Johnson as Payton replaces 3. He can bring them back within 6. Does so, 27 seconds. It would take foul up by the Spurs in the open court game for the Sonics to have a chance, and it does not happen. Count it. 3-point opportunity, fouled by Dale Ellis.
Strickland gets this ball at half court. He's waiting for this defensive guy. Dale Ellis just doesn't commit to guard anybody, so Rod Strickland just takes it all the way to the hoop. Ideally, if you're Ellis, you stand up there and you got to stop the ball. He doesn't do anything and just allows Strickland all the way to the hoop.
A new tradition, perhaps.
A headbutt there.
Anderson and Green.
Hard to do that without helmet.
Well, that's the last guy I would butt heads with over there, Sidney Green. 116 to 107. Kemp no good, 13 seconds. Spurs have got themselves a five-game winning streak. 21 of their last 26. And they will take a three-pointer into the locker room by the Admiral for a little exclamation point. Thank you. First three-point attempt of the year by David Robinson, and it gets nothing but net. And it makes for a final margin of 119-107, San Antonio. We return in a moment on HSE. Final again, the Spurs' fifth consecutive victory, 119-107. The final margin turns into the biggest margin of the game because of the almost the afterthought three-pointer by David Robinson, his first of the year. He may have to try some more with that type of range.
It looked like he knew exactly what he was doing to close the game.
This really a game of two halves. The Sonics were at their best in the first half. They led at the halfway mark 57-50, and then the Spurs caught on to what they were doing and went back to their game. And once they started playing the game, it was really no contest.
Went pretty similar to the game up in Seattle. Seattle gave themselves a chance to win here, and their big horses just didn't come through. Dale Ellis just shooting blanks there in the fourth, and some really good defense all through the game, I think, affected that. Everybody was banging. I think Sean had a difficult night scoring because he was just throwing his body around.